So TOM40 is this gene that is involved in regulating mitochondria, which are these power houses inside of our cells. And without them, we wouldn't actually be able to really do anything. That basically helps cells to, you know, have their get up and go. So for about 6 some odd years or so, the field had looked at this gene and if it was involved in risk for Alzheimer's or not. And initially it looked really promising, but then several groups tried to replicate this effect and they couldn't actually find anything. And so what I came along and said was basically, what are some other factors that we can look at that might be changing, you know, how this gene is affected in some people versus others? And so I decided to look at family history of Alzheimer's disease, basically whether your mom or your dad developed the disease or not. And what was incredibly striking is the fact that if you have a family history of Alzheimer's disease, then what the gene does seems to be bad, so to speak. But if you don't have a family history of Alzheimer's disease, it seems to be good. So basically, there's a tiny snippet of this gene, which can either be short or it can be very long. So if you have a family history, then it being very long is bad. Basically, that ends up meaning that you're at 5 times the risk for developing Alzheimer's disease. You have a lot more memory loss over about 10 some odd years or so and the like. But if your mom or dad never got the disease, it ends up being that the exact same gene and the exact same length of that gene is actually good. So then you have 1/5 of the risk of developing Alzheimer's, and we don't see any kind of loss of memory. And we see this not only in people who have the disease, but even in middle-aged people who don't have any cognitive problems or anything else like that. And so, you know, it just seems to be like a decades-long kind of an effect where, regardless of where you look at it in the range of the lifespan, that, you know, we see this effect that is happening where basically if you have a long version of this gene and you have family history, it's bad. If you have a short if you have a long version of this gene and you don't have family history, it's good. So this is incredibly exciting for us because this particular gene is, you know, thought to really contribute to Alzheimer's risk, and we're thinking that this could really clarify the literature and kind of what seems to be going on there. And kind of more broadly speaking, what we can do is we can take this into the clinic and say, you know, we want to look at this one particular gene and we want to have some idea about whether you're going to develop this disease or not. Well, this kind of gives us one more tool in that arsenal. And the way I look at this kind of study and why I'm really excited about it is because, you know, much like with the Saturday version of the New York Times crossword puzzle, you know, it's incredibly difficult. We're trying to constantly figure out, okay, like what's 15 across? And so ultimately, I hope this study will give us a definitive answer about this gene so that then other researchers can actually, you know, fill in the blanks, so to speak, and we can have a better idea about why we get this disease or why we don't get this disease and hopefully how to better treat it.